the Los Angeles Lakers getting a much-needed win to tie up the series against the Suns. Everybody looked good on the Lakers. Jalen, what was your biggest takeaway from this win?
Well, my initial takeaway is it would have looked a lot different down the stretch for the Suns, who didn't score a basket had they had Chris Paul. Mm-hmm. With that being said, the aggression of Anthony Davis and the Lakers making a concerted effort to not only get him the basketball, but get him the basketball in and around the paint at the beginning of the game to have him be aggressive going towards the basket. Anytime he and LeBron James play a playoff game and they combine for 31 points like what happened in game one, they're never gonna win. And how about the fact he himself had 34, LeBron had 23. That's what they're gonna need if this team is not only gonna win this series, but Jacoby. That's what it's gonna take every game. Like, yep. This ain't just us talking about game two for the Lakers. If they're gonna win the championship,
you're right.
Both of those guys gotta be flirting with 30s and 10s every game.
And it's not just them. Dennis Schroeder stepped up last night and played really well. But one thing I noticed about the Lakers, though, is the difference between game one and game two, in addition to LeBron and AG's production, was the defense. This was the number one defensive rated team in the NBA. Didn't look like in game one, but they were in all the passing lanes. The game started with AD getting a block, which got him started. Then they put him on the block. I thought their defense was a key in this game to get this win for sure. Now, Jalen, it was a big win for Los Angeles last night, but there was also a huge loss for Los Angeles last night. The Dallas Mavericks, game two, in the Staples Center at home. Let's set up the Mavs against the Los Angeles Clippers. Jalen, this was such an exciting game, and it was another performance from that man, Luka Doncic. The Clippers have no answer for him defensively. What do they do now against Luka?
They're in trouble. Trouble. And as somebody who was resident Clipper bandwagon soon as Kawhi and Paul George did their press conference, I injured my ankle jumping off the bandwagon last year when our king Jokic came back from 3-1.
Yep.
And this year, I looked at the Clippers playing against the Mavs, and I was like, they can't get upset again. They can't get upset again. And you know what it made me realize?
What's
the
that?
Clippers, as a franchise, just can't handle prosperity. Like, every time that they're the favorite, they come up short. Mm-hmm. Kawhi was balling. What also did I tell you that I didn't like about the Clippers at the beginning of this year? I don't like their collection of guards.
No.
Like, I wish they were like one player. You know what I'm saying? And on the perimeter, you mean to tell me all NBA Luka can't get slowed down by Kawhi, PG, and Patrick Beverley at all?
Those are supposed to be three of the best defenders. And let's not forget this, Jalen Rose. The Clippers lost to the Rockets and the Thunder to get this matchup. Now what are you going to do with it?
And also, I told you, it started in Detroit. Tim Hardaway Jr. been on fire.
Yes.
Like MOP ever since that game. And these two games, while you're talking about headliners, let's make sure we acknowledge how he has played and the numbers mm-hmm. that he has put up and how he has shot the ball so very well for three and has given Luka a version of a dynamic duo. Remember
yes.
we were saying that Kristaps Porzingis was going to be the guy that steps up for the Mavs?
He
if they're
well
going to
night.
Eliminate the Clippers, was Tim
well
Hardaway
night.
Jr. Big shout, nephew, getting it done in games one and two.
Tim Hardaway Jr. looks so good. This Mavs team looks so good, and they're led by Luka. It, well, no matter what you did to Luka, switch, double team, blitz. He's got an answer for everything, and he's only in his third year. And there's one thing that I thought while watching Luka play. They've got themselves another franchise cornerstone. They've got themselves another Dirk Nowitzki, and he hit a one-legged three. And guess who was right there in the stands to watch? That man, Dirk Nowitzki. This was a great performance, not just from Luka, but from everyone on this team, including Kristaps Porzingis, who they're going to need if they're going to advance. I love the Dirk-Luka handoff.
Hey, now, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something, dog. I've been watching the NBA since the 70s. I have never seen a player shoot a three off one leg like that so effortlessly and then go in. I have never seen that before.
It's almost like he was showing out, like he wanted Dirk to see it. I swear he looked over to Dirk after he hit it too. And this is the playoffs. And one of my favorite things about this game had nothing to do with the game. My favorite thing about this game happened after the game when it was the Clippers. I can't even say it without laughing. When the Clippers addressed their level of concern after the game. Let's listen to a couple of the Clippers.
I mean, there is none. You know, there is a competition. We got to rise to the occasion. You know, fact of the matter is, if we don't, we're done for. But there's no level of concern.
I'm not concerned. Like I said, they got to win 4 games.
You're not concerned? You're down. You lost the first 2 games at home to Luka, and you have no answer for him, and you're not concerned? Like, why not just be honest and say, you know what? We're in trouble. We got to fight back and win this series.
You know, I don't judge by what people say. I judge by what people do. And when you look at that Paul George interview, he wasn't looking up.
Head down.
He was looking down.
Good brains.
Okay? And Luka, they don't have answers for him, Jacoby, because what I noticed is he has the size, the bulk, and the versatility to go against the bigs like Morris, but still he got the skills to boogie against the smaller guys like Beverly. And for all of those Clipper fans out there, and our producer, Demetrius, is one. Like, I just want you guys to know, if y'all lose in the first round to the Dallas Mavs, after getting bounced last year when you were up 3-1 to the Denver Nuggets, I don't want to hear nothing.
No, here's what's happening. If they get bounced in the first round, I'm going to say it right now. Pat Riley gets on the phone and calls Kawhi Leonard and says, Kawhi, I know you love Southern California, but you're also going to love Southern Florida, and we got a spot for you on the Heat.